video by someone who was born as Joshua Benedict Ihamza, but now goes by Jossy Don1. Yeah. Woo! Welcome to Celebrity Corner. Good afternoon.
Yeah, good afternoon. Sports Radio Vision FM. It's your boy Jossy Don1, live up on your radio.
Yeah. If I bring the Mochaccino Archie out of here, that's her alter ego. Also loves Nigeria. Thank you so much for joining us this afternoon. How do you love in South Africa? Is this your first time here?
Yeah, it's my first time here, but I've been on previous radio stations, different radio stations. Yeah. It was my first time on the show this
afternoon. Yeah, well, welcome. We're so glad that you could join us. Tell us a little bit about your musical journey. Where is Jossy Don1 from musically?
Well, Jossy Don1 is from West Africa, Nigeria, and my musical journey began from West Africa, Nigeria. I started as an actor from the beginning. I never thought I was going to do music professionally. I've said this repeatedly. And my musical journey began when I went to the crew, musical crew back then, like over 12 years ago. And they did a particular track, which was Get It, and they decided to feature me on the track. And after the track, everybody started liking my own verse, you know, and it was more like a happy part of the track, and that was when my musical journey began. I started doing music professionally.
So why the switch from acting to music? Why couldn't you do both?
Well, I'm still doing both, because like I just said, acting was my first love. It is still my first love, and I'm also doing music, so I'm under the same umbrella. It's all about entertainment, so I do acting, and I also do music.
Tell me about yourself. Like, do you
highlight?
Do you do R&B?
What's your sound? Well, my sound originally is a dancehall music. Yeah. I do dancehall music. I sing kind of versatile. I can jump on any tune. I can do hip hop. I can do afro pop. You know, it all depends on the inspiration I get whenever I have a beat or I have a new song. So I'm very versatile, but professionally and originally I'm a dancehall artist.
I just want to know how you came about to do dancehall when you're from Nigeria. I've never really heard of a Nigerian artist who does dancehall. How's the scene over there?
Well, when it comes to dancehall music in Nigeria, not just in Nigeria, Africa in general, it's not a sound that is prior, like the normal secular music that you hear, Afro pop and everything. It's different because it originates from Jamaica. So I've been a music lover right from the one before I started doing music professionally. And when I decided to start doing music professionally, I decided to do dancehall music because I love dancehall music. Mm-hmm. So and it suits my style. So that's why I decided to be a dancehall artist and continue on that path.
But what is your connection to the roots of dancehall, which is Jamaica? Do you have Jamaican friends, do you have family that live there? Where was the first time that you heard dancehall music and thought, that's it, that's what I'm gonna do?
Well, it's way back. My dancehall connection, I think I would say, it started from when I started listening to Shaggy, the Jamaican, icon, and I love his vibe, Shabaran, and that's where the journey of me being a lover of dancehall music,
Way
back. I'm still very much young.
Very much younger. Well, we're gonna hear some of Jossy Don1's music. We're gonna play you a song called Ayo. Hey,
why would
you do? You're an African. Where does Tando come from? I feel like there's a story there.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, most definitely. As you all know, you are South Africans, and Tando, you know what it means. It's all about love.
Yeah.
So Tando is all about love, and I feature the South African artist on this one. And she goes by the name Inga Hina. She was also on Moby Dick's Trigger. So she's the one I can do, and I told her how I wanted to be. She should just do the chorus in South African style, let me do my own style. Mm. And at the end of the day, everything came out perfectly, so that's how I kind of came about.
Well, let's hear this melting part, everybody. Jossy Don1 featuring Becky, and that's all Tando. It's proper. Yeah. Joining us to chat a little bit about his career, his sound. He says he wants to just make good old dancehall music. So you've now collaborated with Inga Hena. Are there any other artists, particularly South African artists, that you'd like to collaborate with?
Yeah, most definitely. It's just that right now I'm working on more myself, but definitely in the nearest future I would love to work with the likes of Questa, Caspar, Yves, and you know, Mochachino, Ochi, you know, there are so many other ones in my mind, but right now, those are the toughest.
Yeah.
That,
I mean, we can call her and ask her if she's keen. I'll check her diary.
I want to ask you, why did you choose South Africa? I mean, I've heard of some Jato artists that are from Ghana. They're really big, the sound is big. Why not choose maybe to go and be in Ghana and do dancehall? Why did you choose South Africa specifically?
Well, the truth behind me choosing South Africa specifically is because I was in South Africa 2012. Mm-hmm. You know, I came here to visit and I came here to check out their musical world, how it is and all that. So mm-hmm. I went back to Nigeria. So that's when I decided to come back to South Africa, you know, and do mm-hmm. more of my sound. So I can, you know, spread it down to Nigeria and the rest of Africa.
And how's it going so far?
Well, so far so good. I wouldn't like to use nothing easy, but it's going to be difficult because, you know, as a foreigner, you've been in a foreign country, you know, the challenges, you know, you have to make it difficult. And, you know, sometimes someone won't accept you for that, like in Nigerian,
yeah.
Or they feel drugly or drug addict or things like that, you know. But, but lately, you know, we're getting there gradually, so the connectivity is there, and, you know, we are doing our thing, so in no time, I believe we'll be there.
I want to talk a little bit about what you think the Nigerian influence has been in the world. We see the likes of Davido, the Starboy, Wizkid doing really big things, Tiwa Savage. What do you think the impact of Nigerians has been on the world?
Well, it's really huge. It's huge. Because kudos to my Nigerian celebrities, brothers, you know, my colleagues in the industry, you know, for creating that path for we, you know, to follow, because they're really putting us on the map. You know, when you say you're a Nigerian artist, everybody think, oh, he's from Nigeria, she's from Nigeria, definitely there'll be something good from this artist. So kudos to our big brothers and big sisters in the college industry, you know, maximum respect to them.
So what would a perfect end to 2020 be? What would you like to achieve in this year?
Well, 2020, you know, my vision in 2020 is to ensure, and by the special grace of God, not by my power, you know, to make sure Jossy don1 is heard in the Nigerian market and known in the whole of Africa, and not to go global, and, you know, qualify.
Well, you've got a new single out, Hangover. You've shot the video for it as well. Tell us more about it and just what you want to do with it.
Well, Hangover is all about, you know, ups and downs. It's all about you being through rough parts of life, and you know, enemies trying to pull you down. You know, you don't want to see you progress. You know, enemies, you know, friends that are your friends, but at the same time, they don't want to see you better than they, or do better than they are doing. So I thought about at the end of the day, by the special grace of God, we're able to scale through, and now we're having a good life, you know, and then they are regretting, you know, why they decided to hate on the people, so that's what the anger was all about. Now the anger is hanging over a while ago.
Ooh, nice. I like that. But what would you say to someone who finds themselves in that situation where they've been going through so much, they've got these frenemies and whatever? What would you tell them in order for them to get over or past that?
Well, the thing is, you know, sometimes you can't really detect who your frenemies are, because sometimes they are hypocrites, you know, they smile, you know, in front of you and behind you, they want to see your downfall. It's just that for you to know your frenemies, just be careful, be cautious, and know who you're bonding with and who the circles are. You know, that's not the best way to deal with it. You know, and just pray to God to expose them one of them. That's the best way to go with frenemies.
That's good advice. That's good advice. Where can we see you? Where are you performing? Where you hanging out? How can we follow you on social media as well?
Well, my social media handles, you can follow me on Instagram, it's Jossy.1. On Twitter, it's Jossy_don1. And on Facebook as well, it's Jossy.1.
That is Jossy.1. Jossy.1.
Yeah.
Well, yeah, let's play how Hangover. I would love to hear it. Jossy.1 joining us in the studio. Just got 10 minutes to 3 o'clock. It's a sports update on Vision View Sports Radio.
Yes.
Hangover
is a tune that I just dropped, so it's not up to a month now, So far so good. The way the people are receiving it is good, and I love the way everybody's happy to share with the world and spread the love.
So why don't you shoot a video so quickly?
Well, you know, I did Hangover over a year ago, or close to 2 years ago, but I just shot the video late October.
Okay.
You know how it is when you're a freelancer, you don't have a sponsor who is doing and we're doing everything all by ourselves. It's not easy to get money to do all these things. So that's just lately that I shot Hangover, and I hope it goes viral and the people, the masses love it.
And what other new music are you hoping to drop this year?
Well, there are so many songs piled up in the studio. I've got a whole lot of tracks, but you know how it is, it's one after the other. I can just drop everything all at once, you know, it's one step at a time. You have to push one before you push the other one. So right now I'm working on singles, and what I'm pushing right now is Hangover, so that is what I'm pushing presently.
Well, there you go, Hangover by Jossy don1. That's the song that we just played for you. Thank you so much for joining us.
No, you're welcome.
And lending us your time and all of the best while you're here in South Africa. Anything that you have planned in terms of performances while you're here?
Yeah, definitely. I'll be going on tour this Thursday during summer this year. And I'll be going to East London, PE. Those are the places for Frank presently, but there are other places I want to be. What present does that speak to you? Who that place is confirmed?
Brilliant. So I'm not defying. Guys, go out in your numbers and support Jossy don1. Thank you so much for joining us on the Sports Update. We'll be back, guys, right after this. Okay, Miguel, you know the drill.
Hallelujah. Celebrity Corner with the dynamic duo, Otidi Simohono and Stimmy Lishilembe.
Sondela, Sondela.
Hey, it's Loiso, and you're tuned into the Sports Update with the lovely dynamic duo, Mars and Tim. Only on Vision View Sports Radio. Keep it locked. Keep it locked. Number one, the Sports Update on Vision View Sports Radio.
So, in terms of the cricket that you can look forward to, the cricket action between New Zealand and India will also be continuing taking place. The T20 is happening at the Park Stadium. You're going to send it to New Zealand up against India at 1 o'clock. It is happening tomorrow, the 31st of January 2020. We've also got the ICC Alamanti Cricket World Cup currently on the go. This is, of course, South Africa taking on Bangladesh. And I'm trying to see the score there, but